Hey guys, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play, being a bit quiet because it's late and I'm downstairs and she's upstairs. And you know, and my voice is a bit boomy, especially when I've got a cold, so it carries. I thought I'd just do a little talkie, just to let you know what I'm doing next, really. As you've probably noticed, I've hit the end of C for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, traditionally what I've done, and I'm talking the Amiga collection that I did, I got from A to C, and I've done hundreds and hundreds of games on the Amiga because there's so many of them, and I was sick of the sight of it, so I decided to move on to a different console, namely the Mega Drive, which was another of my childhood or teenage consoles, and I've done that now. I've hit C. Part of me wants to carry on with it, but part of me wants to explore pastures new, and I think I'll go with that, because if I don't, I'll just end up stuck in D, E and F, and you know, that's fine. I want to get to them at some point, but I sort of want to do something else. First things first, I've got a feeling I'm going to pull back a little bit on the One Go Short Play. Reason being, I love doing it. It's not about the money or anything or making a living off it, but while I'm doing One Go Short Play, I'm not making a living off other things. We're not very well off financially at the moment, I'm struggling, and I've got to find ways to make an income, and while I'm playing video games for you, I can't do that, so I've got to do a bit less gaming. Even though I'm not doing that much, I've still got to do a bit less, and I've got to put that time into things that will make a bit more money. As some of you know, I develop indie games. I've been neglecting that a little bit. I've been developing a game over at Cysoft on Twitter, shameless promotion, if you want to check it out. I just when I do something new on the game, I put it up there. I'm going to be doing a bit of that, but I've also got a few other things on the go that I'm hoping will eventually make some money. We'll see, because we need to make some money. So I think I'm going to be doing a little bit less One Go, because I've been doing it a bit full on, as in most Saturday nights for the last few weeks, on Friday nights as well, or either. Talkie-wise, I also want to do a few things. I'd like to introduce you to my arcade machine, which I made ages. I built it out of a piece of plywood a couple of years ago. I'm sure somebody might have seen it in the office when I'm doing talkies. It's all over my Facebook and that as well. I'm very proud of it. It's just a PC and a shell, but it's great and it works and it hooks up to arcade joysticks. And I want to talk about it, show you it. I probably want to improve the emulator that's on there. It's just a MAME emulator, and you know what MAME's like. Those of you who've used it, different versions run different games. The 3D games never really work, even if the computer's quite good. And it's a Windows 8 computer, it's not that old. We dropped it and cracked the screen, and rather than pay to get it fixed, I shoved it in the arcade machine. Sorry, that was a bear. that was a cough. I shoved it in my arcade machine and hooked it up to a big monitor, and it's great. And I want to show you it and just run through it with you and just show you how it plays. So I want to do a video about that at some point. And the other thing I want to do is, I started, you might remember the last talk you did, I'm pointing over there like it's over there, I showed off some Amiga this time. They weren't the best of them, they were just some that I found lying about. The better ones are up in the attic, in my office. We've got two attics, it's complicated. And I need to get up there to get them, so I'm going to do that at some point in the coming weeks, months, years, who knows. You know, sporadic my videos can be. I'd like to just, I know I've got loads of One Disc games with decent pictures on and the artwork, you know, and I'd like to just show them up. Have a bit of a trip down memory lane, so there's going to be a video of that. The next console I think I'm going to move on to, because I've been getting all of the ROMs for it, is the NES. Main reason being, I never had one. Unlike the Amiga and Mega Drive, I never had an NES. I never really wanted one, because I was a Sega kid that gets had a Master System, Mega Drive, Amiga. Who needs an NES and all that? But it's become apparent to me over recent years, especially working in my school with those kids, that they don't know Sega. Sega didn't really exist for them, for anyone, except my generation in my area of the UK, where all my mates had Sega, and I didn't really realise how big Nintendo was by comparison, and it was, and I want to know why. People saying Nintendo's got better games, I'm going to find out. I bought an NES, I'm going to buy a very select collection of games for it. They've got to be cheap, or cheap enough for me to afford because I'm poor, but they've also got to be good. I'm not having rubbish on it. I don't keep rubbish games unless I really personally like them, and I don't care for rubbish on them, as happens with Cyborg Justice and various other Mega Drive games. So I thought the best way to find out which NES games are good is to play A to Z, or at least A to C. So I'm going to do that next. And finally, the other thing I'm going to do, I've been talking about doing this for ages, I'm going to do it. Games what I have made. Basically, as some of you guys know, I've worked in games for 15 years. The last year was my first and only year out of the games industry, and it was a sad year for me because it's made us poor. It's made me quite depressed about my skill set. I can do loads of gamey stuff, but not the things that they want now, and the specific things that they want now. And it's a bit sad. It means that I'm making my own games, yeah, when I get the time, but it also means I'm doing graduate level jobs. Technical stuff. I'm getting recognised for being quite technically adept now, and hopefully it'll go somewhere, but I miss making games, I miss it. And I want to lament the good times I've had making them, so I think what I'm going to do, probably using my portfolio as a source, because I've forgotten half the ones I've worked on, and there's about 60 odd in there, and so a lot of them are the same engine and not really worth bringing up because of mobile games and card games and stuff like that, and you don't want to see that necessarily. So I might just give a few examples of those ones, but the ones I'm really proud of, like the 16-bit era ones when I started, I want to get them onto a video, so I'm going to start with that. I don't know whether I'll do it while I'm doing the next thing. I might do the two kind of separately, but you know, over the same, concurrently, is that the word, where you do things at the same time? Anyway, at the same time, just so I can dart between the two playlists, if you like, and keep it interesting for me. So look out for those. A few more talkies of those subjects I've just discussed, a few more some NES videos, and some games that I worked on, and I'll talk about what I did on them and what my memories are of them. Some of them are more potent than others, and yeah, that's pretty much what I've got coming, and also not quite as frequent, so I've been uploading every few days on average. It might stay like that if I can keep it up, but I'm not sure it will, because I've got to get on with some other things too. I know you guys understand that. I know you guys will stick with me. You know me, I come and go, but I'm always there, I'm always back again. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. And I will endeavour to do more answering questions for people's other YouTube channels. For a moment there in my new job, I had some time where I wasn't really working that hard and intensively, and I was able to watch YouTube while I worked. And then it became intensive, where I had to learn new software. Very sort of creative technical stuff, and I've kind of managed that scripting and whatnot, so I couldn't really watch YouTube while I was doing it, and I had to deal with audio as well, so I couldn't listen. That seems to be calming down a bit now, where I'm getting into flow of making stuff, and then a moments there where I'm able to listen and watch YouTube, so I might be able to get more interactive with that again, and hopefully start answering videos and doing a bit of that too. But as I say, it won't be quite as frequent as it has been, so bear with me, stick with me. And as always, thanks for watching.